We humans cannot know the future before it happens, but that does not stop us from trying. From weather and sports, to our money and health, to the economy and politics. Every day we anticipate how life would unfold because that brings the comfort of certainty. However, when anticipations turn out to be wrong, they can really turn our lives upside down. During the presidential election last November, we together experienced the unexpected. Back then, pollsters and media all forecasted a Clinton win with so much certainty that in retrospect was largely unwarranted. Now, I do not study the election myself, but the election was a humbling experience for me as a statistician, whose job is to research models to help establish anticipations. So today, I hope to explain to you why conventional statistical models may have led us to be overly certain when it comes to talking about uncertainty. The way models work in general is that they take in information and produce probabilities to describe the likely cases we're anticipating. However, the thing is, current models are designed only to handle precisely specified input information and will not apply when this information is hazy. What do I mean by that? Well, for a model, precise information is like seeing a point in space. The nice thing about points is that they are all well separated from one another, so that the white point is decisively different from the orange, and so is the green. However, as it turns out, scientific information, be it data or expert judgments, often takes on a hazy form, encompassing many points at the same time. In our terminology, these are called sets, and unlike points, sets have complicated relationships with one another, thus are much harder to deal with mathematically. Currently, all models must choose to circumvent this hazy information by pretending everything is point-valued and well-separated. But in doing so, we're making things up, not because we believed it, but rather the model forced us to. While often convenient, this can sometimes be dangerous. In my dissertation research, I work to expand the possibility for models to directly handle set-valued input information. I incorporate theories on random sets into classic statistical inference in order for models to have this expanded vocabulary to talk about anticipations. The difference this makes can be astounding. Let me take this example of election forecast. Imagine now that we live in a simple world where there are only two parties, and whichever wins the popular vote wins the election. As we go out and conduct polls, there will always be voters whose preference we won't know, either because they did not pick up the phone or they haven't made up their mind. This creates a hazy piece of information in our data, and the current models don't like that. In order to proceed, the model asks us to either throw away this voter or, more sophisticatedly, replace him or her with a random calculated guess to reflect our past experience. Only till then can the model proceed with an estimate together with error bars to reflect the variability due to a small sample size. But think about it. An undecided voter is someone who could really vote for either parties. So in my modeling approach, this voter will be encoded as a set with two possible values. And the logical thing to do there is to put this voter into a third category of whose preference we don't know. Now, as we go on and collect data on more and more voters, look what happens. If we proceed with the guessing route, the power of big data will kick in, and we will obtain a very precise estimate of the vote share no matter which way we guess. Whereas if we don't guess, this category of don't know, however small, will linger and refuse to be washed away by the sheer size of data. Now here comes the important question, who will win the election? Again, in the simple world, this comes down to comparing our estimate with the number 50%. Well, in this case, the guessing root will confidently predict a Democratic win, which of course would be great if we knew we made all the right guesses and got the vote share precisely right. But how would we know? Had we been guessing differently, this model could have been confidently predicting both kinds of outcomes. One must wonder if any of it deserved the confidence to begin with. On the other hand, the small category of don't know opens our anticipation to a large range of possibilities. The model is essentially saying that with the information at hand, we just can't be sure of the election result. And in hindsight, that would have been a helpful thing to know before the election took place. What I want to say is, model borrowed their strength from mathematics because of its unparalleled precision. But precision is not a license to think that just about everything can be foreseen. I develop statistical models that will admit to being unsure when information is hazy, and that itself is a virtue, a reminder for us to stay proactive instead of thinking wishfully and be let down in the end. The future, after all, is not about what we anticipated yesterday, but rather what we create today. Thank you.